Good morning, everyone. Welcome to Sagar Group of Institution. I am Mrs. Payal Saitu, working as Associate Professor at SIRTS Pharmacy Group. And I am taking Pharmacognosy and Pharmacochemistry 2, BP5014. For my today's lecture, the topic is mevalonic acid pathway. So let us understand what is the basically the compound is all about and why it is important to understand mevalonic acid pathway. Since the syllabus and the first unit of mevalonic chapter is deals with the secondary metabolites, so we need to understand how secondary metabolites are synthesized in the plant kingdom or in the animal kingdom. So it is important to understand what is metabolite first. So metabolites are the intermediate product produced during the metabolism, and in this we are going to discuss about plant metabolites. There are two types: primary metabolites, secondary metabolites, and the difference between primary metabolites, secondary metabolites, and mevalonic acid pathway. Metabolites are the intermediate product produced during the metabolism. For an example, there are a number of metabolites which are produced during the metabolism in the human as well. Find there are a number of hormones which are synthesized, like your progesterone, testosterone, which is synthesized in the body, like your cholesterol, like any other or substances which are synthesized in the body. Similarly, these are substances which are synthesized in the plant and animal kingdom as well. They perform various metabolite functions, as like fueling, like you need energy, you need for the growth and development, you need it for the your defense mechanism. And so they act as a fuel, they act as a structure signaling, they catalytic activity depends on interaction with other organisms. The metabolites are produced by plant, human, and microbes. Okay, so every creature, they produce some metabolites. Human have 2500 metabolites. I have given the example: cholesterol, steroidal hormone, catecholamines, vitamin K, okay, a number of amino acids as well. Plant metabolites, they are two types: primary metabolites and secondary metabolites. Primary metabolites, they are primary products which are required for the growth and development of the organism itself. They are also involved in primary metabolic process like respiration, photosynthesis. And they are intermediate product of anabolic metabolism, which are used by the cell for the formation of essential macromolecules. Amino acid, vitamins, organic acids, some of the primary metabolites produced initially industrially. So this is all about primary metabolites and secondary metabolites. These are the compounds produced by the organisms that are not required by the organisms as by like primary metabolites. Yes, but they are the product of end product of secondary primary metabolism. Secondary metabolites are examples like different compounds which are being produced in the plants and animals, like cholesterol. I have already given the examples. Since they are the secondary metabolites, whereas primary metabolites examples are like carbohydrates, your number of other substances which are used as the energy as used for the development phase. And secondary metabolites, they are the product of end product of primary metabolism. This is the basic difference between primary metabolites and secondary metabolites. Required for the growth and maintenance of cellular function, involved in ecological function. Primary metabolites occur at growth phase, whereas secondary metabolites occur at stationary phase. Produced in large amount and easy to extract, whereas secondary metabolites are produced in small amount and difficult to extract because you need to have a particular solvent, a particular mechanism, a particular procedure through which you can extract primary and secondary metabolites. Same in every species because primary metabolites are same in every species because since they are required for the production, for the growth and development, they are used in the growth and development phase. They are basically produced during the development phase, so they are common in every species. Whereas secondary metabolites, different species, perform physiological function in the body. Primary metabolites, they perform physiological function in the body. Whereas secondary metabolites, they are derived from primary metabolites. Example, carbohydrate, vitamins, ethanol, lactic acids, these are primary metabolites. Whereas phenolics, steroids, terpenoids, pigments, these are your secondary metabolites. Today for the topic basically is a mevalonic acid pathway. And this is one of the important pathway required for the synthesis of terpenoids is steroids. And the main important step where usually the starting phase, I should say, is when your HMG coenzyme reductase act on a compound to get it converted to mevalonic acid, where it get again get converted to different steroids and terpenes. And HMG 3-hydroxy-3-methylbutyryl coenzyme A reductase enzyme. So this is one of the key steps in mevalonic acid pathway. So remember, mevalonic acid is a key compound in the synthesis of terpenes and steroids. So if we say that in a body cholesterol is being formed, if we say terpenoids is a terpenoidal drug, it's a steroidal drug. So that means the drug in that organism, that living creature, mevalonic acid pathway is running on. Mevalonic acid is very solvent, water and polar organic solvent. It exists in equilibrium with its lecton form called mevalonate lectone. Biologically, mevalonic acid is a primary precursor of isopentyl pyrophosphate. So mevalonic acid pathway comes at an end where it forms isopentyl pyrophosphate, and from where it's going to transform into a different terpenoids. Mevalonic acid is a chiral, and mevalonic acid is a chiral and enantiomers, which is only a biological active compound. Mevalonic acid pathway, it is an important pathway, like eukaryotes, archaea, and some bacteria. Unlike shikimic acid pathway, which only takes place in plants and microorganisms and lower in organisms, from that it differs from that it occurs in eukaryotes, archaea, and bacteria. So that means every organism is having a cycle of mevalonic acid pathway. Like unlike shikimic acid pathway, because shikimic acid pathway is a pathway which forms amino acids, so essential amino acids. So human does not have a shikimic acid pathway. That means we need to take this from plant sources or organism sources. But mevalonic acid pathway takes place in eukaryotes, archaea, and some bacteria. The pathway produces two carbon building blocks called isopentyl pyrophosphate and dimethylallyl pyrophosphate. So this pathway forms two 5 compound building blocks. Okay, that is isopentyl pyrophosphate and dimethylallyl pyrophosphate, which are again get combined together, fused together to give different kinds of biomolecules such as cholesterol, vitamin K, coenzyme Q10, and all steroid hormones. Mevalonate coenzyme pathway begins acetyl coenzyme A and ends with production of IPP and DMPK. Best known as a target of statins, statins are act as a drug which lowers the blood cholesterol level. So this drug basically inhibits HMG coenzyme reductase. HMG is 3-hydroxy-3-methylbutyryl coenzyme A in reductase enzyme, which converts it into mevalonic acid. So if this enzyme is not going to act on the pathway, mevalonic acid is not going to be formed. And if mevalonic acid is not going to be formed, that means your other biomolecules, cholesterol, vitamin K, steroid hormones is not going to form. So statin inhibit HMG coenzyme reductase enzyme. Regulation, how does a body nose has a signal to produce cholesterol? So there is an intracellular sensor detect low cholesterol level and stimulate endogenous production of HMG coenzyme reductase in pathway. Okay. So when this level of cholesterol get decreases in your body, there is a intracellular sensor which senses the low level of cholesterol, and this stimulates the production of HMG coenzyme reductase pathway. And this is how it's run. And this we can say a feedback mechanism. Pharmacologically, we can say a number of drug target mevalonic pathway like statins, biphosphates. Mevalonic acid pathway, if the mevalonic acid pathway is in excess or it is decreasing, if it is inhibiting, something is a deficiency and disease can occur. One of the deficiencies is mevalonate kinase deficiency. Mevalonate kinase deficiency is the deficiency which gives mevalonic aciduria, hyperimmunoglobulinemia, D syndrome. These are two diseases. We are going to discuss this later. What are these diseases? And what are the signs and symptoms and how you can identify the person is suffering from deficiency of mevalonic acid or excess of mevalonic acid. This is mevalonic acid pathway. and starts with the acetyl coenzyme A. So let me tell you where this pathway is going to take to. This pathway is going to take place in the cytosol, and this pathway forms ubiquinones. Ubiquinones is one of the active compounds responsible for the lipoprotein transport chain in the mitochondria. And so this is where it enters in mitochondria. Initially, within the cell, it forms the cytosol. So it starts with the acetyl coenzyme A. So we get acetyl coenzyme A from pyruvate in the glycolysis pathway. So the two molecules of acetyl coenzyme A combine, and it forms acetoacetyl coenzyme A. On this enzyme, HMG coenzyme A synthase act. 3-hydroxy-3-methylbutyryl coenzyme synthase act, which forms 3-hydroxy-3-methylbutyryl coenzyme A. And on this HMG coenzyme reductase acts, where it gets converted into mevalonic acid. From mevalonic acid, it gets converted to mevalonate phosphate. Mevalonate phosphate to mevalonate pyrophosphate. Mevalonate pyrophosphate to isopentyl pyrophosphate. We are using the term pyrophosphate when two phosphate groups are combined at the position. Then from there, dimethyl pyrophosphate, dimethyl allyl pyrophosphate. And these two combined, dimethyl pyrophosphate and isopentyl pyrophosphate, combine together to form your geranyl pyrophosphate, from geranyl pyrophosphate to farnesyl pyrophosphate, which is going to form sterols, diacrons, and different squalenes, cholesterols. So this is the small screen where you can see what are the different end products of mevalonic acid pathway. So you can see from geranyl pyrophosphate, it gets converted to farnesyl pyrophosphate, farnesyl to squalene, and farnesyl will get through the production of farnesylate proteins, dolichols, KMA, ubiquinones. From farnesyl is again going to convert into squalene, from squalene to lanosterol, lanosterol to dihydrocholesterol, from dihydrocholesterol to cholesterol. Dihydrocholesterol is going to convert into vitamin D, which is going to convert into bile acids, steroid hormones, head cone proteins. So when we say the drug acetyl coenzyme A, the drug like statin or drug which lowers the cholesterol in the body, it acts here at inhibiting the conversion of 3-hydroxymethylbutyryl coenzyme A to mevalonic acid. And if it is get inhibited, then you get you have the MPK deficiency, which is mevalonic acid kinase deficiency. This is for today. Thank you so much for joining me.